Hi and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I have a fun project. I will be using a new dye by My Favorite Things and I will be creating three different treat bags. Now this is a dye that has just been released. It gives you three different ways to create the handles for your little treat bags and of course you can separate it here. I will leave it for the first treat bag as it is, but for the next ones I will be showing you how you can use the rest of the handles. For my first treat pack, I'm going with pink cardstock and you can see that you can get one treat pack out of one cardstock easily. Creating little treat bags is a favorite thing of mine. I don't know why I love them so much. I find them so cute and it's a really fun process. So I need to cut out two of those shapes. And I will be using my bone folder to reinforce those score lines that you get when you use the die. And I will repeat the same process on the other cutout, so I will end up with two identical pieces looking like this. I have already added some score tape on the flaps. Now I'm going to remove the backing and put my little treat bag together. Now you will end up with two identical pieces that you can slide one on top of the other. And the box comes together really easy. At the bottom you can use some white glue like I will be doing here. Or you can use score tape as well. I am going to show you this, how to put the treat bag together once, but you will see three different variations on how you can use it. It is really easy to put together and you can really easily mass produce it, especially if you want to create party favors and you need a lot of those. I'm using my bone folder to reach inside and press those flaps and squeeze towards the inside and my little treat bag is ready and looking super cute. The size of it is really good, it fits nicely little treats like you can see here. You can also fit inside a gift card. I also enjoy making my own handmade jewelries and this is the perfect size for those to hand them out to my friends. Now if you are not mass producing this bag, then I'm going to show you a really fun way to decorate it. But if you are mass producing it, you really need to work fast, so I will show you two more ways at the end of this video. So for this one I'm going with a new stamp set which is called Sweetest Sun Bunny. It is absolutely adorable, it features this lovely bunny and two more in different positions. And I'm also going to stamp some of the grass and the flowers that come in the same stamp set. Now for these little stamps I'm going to do a two-color stamping, so only at the base I'm touching with some green ink and then at the bottom I'm going to use my lavender ink pad. Just because I'm using those little ink cubes, I can easily see where I'm adding ink and I don't need to do any masking at all for these little images. Now I went ahead and used my alcohol markers to add some color on the bunny. I'm keeping the bunny mostly white, so I'm only going to add some pink touches as well as some light gray shadow, and I use the matching dies to cut out everything. Now I'm going to use all those die cuts and create a little scene at the front of my bag. For that I'm using my white glue at the back of all those cutouts, and my little bunny is going to sit on the grass and have some little flowers surrounding him. Now this is a bag that would take a little bit more time to create since it has all that beautiful decoration at the front, but it's a one little treat bag for a special gift. You can also hang a little tag with from and to on top. I am going with a new die cut again that is called Hashtag Captions and I'm going to use the one that says sweet. This die cut is one of the new ones and it comes with three sentiments, smile, sweet and hello, as well as the little hashtag. I was planning to use the hashtag on this bag, but you will see that it doesn't fit, so I just went with the word sweet. I'm using the negative space here to make sure that my letters are nicely aligned. So this completes my little treat bag. I am going to tie a little bow at the top to keep it closed. I think it is really adorable and you can use any stamp that you have on hand to make it super cute. So here are some close-up photos on this treat bag and then I'm going to show you two more ways on how you can create really easy treat bags that look really professional but they are super easy to recreate for when you need lots and lots of them for your party favors. I'm going to cut out this treat bag using craft cardstock, I'm laying on top the little handle as well as the sentiment that says hello from the captions die set, and I will secure them together with some purple tape. And make sure to use some tape to keep those three dies together so that you can remove them from the paper and put them on another one and cut out more and more multiples without having to place those two little dies inside again and again. So you can cut out as many panels as you need with the hello, and for the backing I just cut out only with the handle. Now I'm going to put the treat back together just like I did with the first one. Now this is where I realized that I die cut the word hello very close to the edge, so the flap is going to cover the back, which is something that I don't want, so that's really easy to solve. I'm just going to use my scissors and turn this flap really small. So you can see this is not going to overlap the die cut, and I can go ahead and assemble my treat back as normal. For this design I'm going with really neutral colors, so you can easily hand it out as a treat bag to both boys and girls, and I'm just going to tie a double knot with some string. Now if you want to add an extra touch, you can add a little clothespin like I'm doing here. This is really easy and quick to recreate, and you can make tons of them. It's just die cutting and sticking everything together. For my last one, I'm going to work on white cardstock. This time I'm using the little sentiment that says smile. I'm going to secure it down with purple tape. Remember, if you are mass producing this, make sure to connect those two dies together so you don't have to align them every time. Now I'm going for some inlay die cutting here, so I need to have some backing for the back of the word smile. That's why I'm going to stick this white piece there. And then I use my alcohol markers to color in those letters. And I'm going to stick them right inside the gaps. I love how clean and simple this treat bag looks, but at the same time it's colorful and happy. And if you have little kids that want to help out for those treat bags, then I'm sure they will be really happy to color in the letters for you. Now you can use a clothespin like I showed you in the previous one to keep this closed, really quick and simple, or if you want you can stick the handles. For that I'm just going to use some white glue, hold it there for a few seconds. I love that with Nouveau Deluxe it grabs really quickly, and I'm going to make sure that the back handle is nicely aligned with the one at the front. And I just tied a little twine to keep it closed. With this die you can create so many different variations, and of course you can die cut it using pattern paper. So here are all the treat bags together, and here is the standard gift card where you can see that it fits nicely inside. So that was the project for today, featuring new dies and stamps from the latest release by My Favorite Things. You can find links to the products that I used in this video, just like always, down below in the description area as well as on my blog. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I hope you will all have a lovely day.